unbelievable.
Dramatic pictures this evening. Capitola Avenue in the heart of the downtown district turned into a raging river, sliming everything in its path, and that is just the beginning. Good evening, everyone. I'm Erin Clark. Dan Green is off tonight. We are beginning on the storm watch in Capitola, where tonight there is a lot of damage, but also many people in distress. A mobile home park is in ruins, and many businesses are flooded out. Action News reporter Tom Miller begins our live team coverage from Santa Cruz.
Well, Erin, many of the people forced from this mobile home park are elderly, and they have no idea if or when they'll be allowed back into their homes. That's just adding anxiety to an already stressful situation.
Oh, my God.
That's the voice of Kathy McDonald. She was working in her second-story office in downtown Capitola this afternoon when she heard a roar.
I was sitting at my desk on the phone, and suddenly I heard this huge roaring sound, and I turned to look out the back window, and it was suddenly rushing down right over there in these huge torrents, which looked like a tsunami.
For a time, no one was really sure what happened or where the water was coming from. The Soquel Creek was running high, but wasn't quite at flood stage. But the river of mud and debris kept coming, roaring through the town for almost half an hour.
The businesses will probably be closed, I would suspect, three or four days already. They're starting to put themselves back together, but this is something we haven't experienced before.
Turns out a culvert under pressure from the Soquel Creek and other tributaries gave way, sending water rushing all the way down this way and into town. To make matters worse, a nearby mobile home park had its ground collapse along with the culvert. This is what the park looks like now.
We have to figure out a place for these people to live, and we don't know how long it's going to take to get back in there. So we have 56 families that have been displaced because of this flooding.
56 families forced out of their homes, and most of the downtown district of Capitola flooded out. Whatever was in the way when the water came through was affected, even this police car. As for Kathy McDonald, it's something she's not going to forget anytime soon.
It was coming down the hill. But it was going so fast and furiously, and I looked down at my car in the parking lot, and it was a foot underwater. And after everything that's gone on with Japan, I started imagining we're having some kind of a tsunami, and my car is going to float away.
And Erin, all of those structures in the park have been red tagged, so no one's going to be allowed back into the park until a full engineering evaluation has been conducted. Back to you.
All right, Tom, thank you.